deine 3 Minuten starten.
Okay. Ladies and gentlemen, did you ever wonder why animals end up in our barbecue and not the other way around? We are not stronger than cows, but the power of our brain is extraordinary. Through evolution, from mice to monkey till human, the number of neurons in the brain has increased, especially in the cortex, the intelligence area. And we humans have more neurons in the cortex than any other animal on Earth. And scientists believe this is the reason why our brain is such an extraordinary machine. But what was the strategy of evolution to get us so many neurons? Well, for sure you heard about stem cells. These master cells that by dividing can either multiply themselves or produce any other cell of our body, like skin cells, muscle cells, or neurons, for example. So basically, while our brain is growing in the belly of our mom, stem cells are the mothers of the neurons that will fill up our adult heads. Now, luckily for you, I go nowhere without my stem cell explanatory kit. Let's imagine a brain being formed with just one stem cell. This stem cell could produce 2 neurons by dividing once. And so we get a brain with 2 neurons, that's it. Now, let's go back to the same brain, but in this case, the stem cell divides and multiplies itself. And now, with 2 stem cells, we could get a brain with 4 neurons, double as many. And this is a key point, because while our brain is growing in the belly of our mom, our stem cells multiply much more before producing neurons as compared to the ones of mice or monkeys. And this is how we end up having a couple of billion more neurons in our cortex. Thanks, evolution, by the way. But now, multiplying or producing neurons, how do stem cells decide? Well, in my lab, we found this is a matter of time. Multiplying is fast, but producing neurons is complicated, takes longer. And so I decided to play the master of evolution, and I found a way to trick this clock. So a stem cell will be there in the brain, or like, should I multiply now, or just call it a day and produce a couple of neurons tomorrow, huh? And this is when I come along and stop the clock. And so stem cells have no other choice but to multiply. So I get more stem cells, and later on, more neurons. And when we do that with mice in the lab, they actually get bigger brains and are smarter. And why is this important? Well, because right now, in our brains, we all have stem cells that keep on dividing throughout life, facing the same time dilemma, which is fine. But unfortunately, we also happen to be very often affected by diseases, such as Parkinson or Alzheimer's, which kill neurons like crazy, and our brain cannot work without neurons. And I think we could help the brain recovering from these diseases by using my strategy for increasing the number of neurons, just as evolution did before. Thank you.